Hi everyone, welcome to Stunner Share. So today in this video what we are going to see is the next month analysis for the September as well as the current week analysis, and at the end I'll try to post the post market analysis for today also. So let's move on to the analysis so that we'll be able to understand what is actually happening. So now actually we are into the monthly chart. So this is the monthly chart what we are having over here. So what actually I feel is like market did not have a proper close above the March month's high. For example, this is the March month high around 11,433, and we had a close of the August month around 11,387. I was expecting a close above 11,430, but unfortunately we did not have the close. So that means this point or this zone can act as a stiff resistance. So now for any other up move to further continue, we need at least a proper close to happen above this 11,789 or 11,800 zone to further move up. So this is what we are expected in a monthly time frame. So I'm just trying to see, is there any other patterns or any other chart which has happened the same way? I could see something over here. For example, if you could see over here, this one candle in a month candle fallen around 600 points over here, and the month high was around this zone, and this candle which formed after some 4-5 months did not have a close, and after that it gave a good close about to rally up further. So to be more precise, what I could say is like we need a close above this August month candle to move further upside. So this is what I can say with respect to month chart. So now when we are moving into weekly chart, so weekly chart for till August 28, it was good. And after that, the 31st August candle, which is formed an engulfing candle, it is the worst part of the. So what we can do now is like we need to wait for the candle to get completed. Okay, so this candle for yesterday, it was looking like a bearish and engulfing candle, but today it showed a slight pullback. So what I would say is like, if suppose this candle's low is going to break further down and get a close in a daily chart or an hourly chart, then we can see further downside of 10,860 levels, or this low is the first target, 11,120 and 11,850 or 870 zone will be the second target. So until and unless this particular candle's low is not getting broken, we will not be facing any issue at all. For example, let's take this candle. This candle also similarly look like a candle wherein which we would have faced some bearish engulfing, but then it closed up and the low was not at all broken till now. So till now this low was not broken. So the same way, again, if suppose this candle's low is not going to get broken, then we will be trending upside only. If suppose if it is getting broken, then we may see some further upside, further downside. So let us go to daily chart so that we'll get some more understanding. So let me show this also. One sec. So this candle, which was formed on 8th of June. So let's go to that day and that particular day and see what has actually happened. So this is the one particular candle which has happened on 8th of June. So ultimately the pullback was seen on the Friday of that week. And if you guys see over here, this is a bearish engulfing candle. It is a good bearish candle, but still not an engulfing candle. But then this low is not broken and ultimately we moved upside. So the same way, if suppose this candle's low is not going to get broken, then we will be trending upside only. So anyways, let's see whether the low is going to get broken or not. So we are now, till yesterday, it was like we were in a bearish bias wherein the engulfing candle is actually engulfed 1 week of movement. For example, Thursday, Wednesday, Tuesday, Monday, this entire week of candle movement has been completely engulfed in a Monday candle itself. So that is why I was very bearish on Nifty. So if in case this low of 11,325 to 320 zone is getting broken, then we can see 11,080 zone and then we will be able to see 10,850 zone. So let's wait for that. But the same way, I also saw negative divergence, RSI negative divergence. So let me draw that and explain so that you guys will be able to get an understanding. So if you guys see over here, a divergence over here as seen here. So this point to this point, the price was moving up, a higher high was formed. But in the case of RSI, a lower high has been formed. So this shows some RSI negative divergence. So as far, so based on that, yesterday I gave a target saying that 10,030 to 10,300 to 10,330 can be possible. That is how the target was defined yesterday. So this is the RSI divergence we could see. So but then we also need to know whether this particular point is going to get broken or not in RSI, then only we'll be able to understand what exactly can happen. Because if suppose this particular point is going to get broken, then RSI positive divergence will be forming, because the RSI will be forming a lower low, whereas the Nifty would not have touched 10,850 also. So at that time RSI positive divergence also will be seen. So we need to wait for those particular zones to react on how the market can behave. So with respect to price action, candlestick patterns and all those things, as per monthly chart, Nifty did not close above the March month's high, and it had a close below it. Now for further up move, we need the close above the current month, which means the August month's high, to perform further upside. Clear. And what I also could see in RSI, it's like RSI is also facing a trend line test point, and that is what I could see a fall can have. Okay, anyways, we will just wait and watch on how the market is going to react this month, so that we will be able to decide whether we are going to upside or whether we are going to go for downside. And as per weekly chart, we are yet to get a confirmation if you are going to be very bearish. If suppose the bearishness to continue, then the Monday's low of 11,325 has to be broken and close, and then only we will be able to see some downside move. Otherwise, we will not be we'll not be having a big downside move. So that is what is very, very important. And now coming to daily time frame, the same daily time frame, we need a close either above the yesterday's candle or either below the yesterday's candle to decide which direction it can go. So as far as now, we are going good. We are not in a much bad shape for now. Only the yesterday candles were giving a much struggle. So coming to moving average part, I'll just show certain things on this. Okay. So as per moving average, what I could see is like this is the 200 MA moving average. If suppose a fall is going to come, then this 20 EMA or the 20 SMA has to get broken. If that zone is getting broken convincingly, then we will be able to see this zone. So in case if any 50 MA is also coming, then we will not be, will be facing. So if any 50 MA coming, then we might take a support at 11,030 also. Anyways, 50 MA, 20 MA, 200 MA, all those are lagging indicators. For example, if suppose Nifty is going to go bit up, then this moving average will be moving upper side. So that means the amount of fall can be restricted, because 20 MA mostly don't attract the candles. They always reject the candles. So we might see some upper side also. So anyways, this lagging indicator do not give much trust. But what I would say is like if suppose 20 MA is going to get broken, then we will be able to see 50 MA and the 20 MA as per the moving averages. So now let's move on with the weekly CPR and then the monthly CPR. So let me move on first to the weekly CPR, and then I'll show about the monthly CPR. So as far as considering the weekly CPR, it is a higher value CPR. Okay, it is a higher value CPR. Even today, this week is a higher value CPR. And what we could see is like Nifty has engulfed the CPR convincingly. So now what we need to see, we need to check whether any other possible support and resistance are there. So Nifty has taken the support at weekly S2 and trying to move upper side. So let's see whether again if this low is going to get broken, then we can see further downside also. The only biggest negative point is yesterday's bearish engulfing candle is the biggest negative point. Anyways, let's see how market is going to react for that. And then now let us go and see how the monthly pivots are looking like. The monthly pivots are also looking like the monthly CPR is also on higher value relationship, where you can see this higher value relationship is seen. So ultimately what I would say is like, let me go to a 1 hour chart, because so that I can show this CPR width. So if you guys see over here, the CPR width is very, very narrow compared to the previous CPR. So what I would say is like this month can be a trending month. It can go any side. And currently today the market is taking support at the weekly low as well as the monthly pivot TC. If in case any break below the monthly CPR, then we will be able to see some monthly low also, which is the previous monthly low, which is lying around 10,900 zone. This is the previous month low, which is around 10,800 zone, 870 zone. So ultimately, if any downside, if we are able to see, then we have to first break the previous week low and then the monthly CPR zone, which can be easily broken because it is a very, very narrow CPR. So it can get engulfed easily. And after that, if it is going to continue the fall, then the last support, what I could see is 10,877 as per monthly CPR. So if in case market has to trend high, it has to break the previous week high and previous month high to further trend upside. So again, I'm saying if suppose the yesterday's candles low is not going to get broken, then we can still see further upside move to continue. And more further move to continue, we need a close above the August month high so that we will be going towards our all-time high. So this is all about the update or the weekly or the monthly analysis for Nifty. Let's check what Bank Nifty says and let us move further with that. So this is the Bank Nifty chart. Let me remove all the things. Three time frame. So monthly time frame, what I would say is like bullish to my eyes, because above the July month, we got a close of August month, and then we can still further see upside also. But the only one thing is like it is facing some resistance at the supports, earlier support zone. So these are the three support zones. So now the same place it is facing some resistance. So if it is able to break and close convincingly, then we will be further trending upside towards some targets of 28,000 to 29,000. So this Bank Nifty, as per me, it is looking a bit bullish as per monthly time frame. As per weekly time frame also, it is looking bullish. So what I would still say is like Bank Nifty might come for a pullback, and yesterday that pullback has also been seen. If suppose this is the pullback which has happened, and if it is going to reverse, then we will see further upside also. Bank Nifty will be in danger, will be positionally very weak, will be in danger only if this low is going to get broken. So this low is coming around 21,000. Why this low is getting broken is like a simple higher low concept. This is the low form, this is the lower high, and this is the higher low. And after that, and again higher high, and then a higher low, and then a higher high. So if it is taking a support over here, it can move further up. If it is going to break further down, still if it is able to take a support over here, it can move further up. Suppose if it is going to break convincingly and give a close below this line, then we have to see further down, which I'm not expecting at all for now. We might see some correction to happen like this till up to 21,000, but not much below that. I'm not expecting 9,500 to break in Nifty. So that is for sure. So then daily time frame, this is what we could see. So daily time frame also gives a clear picture of what can happen. So this is the overall market pullback zone which I'm expecting. So this is the overall pullback zone. So it can come around over here also, not an issue. If it is taking a support over here also, then also fine. 23,200 will be the good zone of support and where we can see some upside move. So anyways, like in the case of Nifty as well as in the Bank Nifty. And one thing if you guys notice over Nifty is like the Bank Nifty, yesterday's candle did not engulf much of the data. Even yesterday's candle did not engulf the previous day's candle. See, the closest bit up only. But in the case of Nifty, it has engulfed completely. So that means it is not getting enough support from Reliance. So Reliance has to trend upside, then only we'll be able to get some upside move. So we're in the same case of Nifty and Bank Nifty. If this yesterday's low is going to get broken, then 23,200 will be the zone of taking support. Further breaking down will take us to 22,000. And if some 21,000 is going to get broken, then we might enter a bearish trend. So until unless if 21,000 is not broken, we are still in the upside move. So we have to ride the trend convincingly. So with respect to moving average, as I said in the weekend analysis, what I've shared in the thread in Twitter, the same thing what has happened, it was facing a resistance at the 200 MA. I can also show you guys the same thing. Let me take it out. Let me take it down. I should have bookmarked it, I guess. I am missing it. Okay, here it is. So if you guys see over here, Bank Nifty is looking bullish with a good breakout. It's in 200 MA can act as a good resistance, which is over 25,100 to 25,200 zone, which is the exactly the high made 25,232. And after that, it faced a good resistance at around the 200 MA and started coming down. So if in case the same way, if it can still move up, move down over here 22,700, and the worst case we can see around 22,230, where it can take some support at around 50 EMA or 50 MA. So let's wait and watch. For now, Bank Nifty is not looking more bullish to my eyes. So let's wait for it. So now let's move on with the analysis with respect to CPR. And the CPR, after a long time, yes, it is looking like a, it is looking as higher value CPR. So any trend, any support taken at CPR can be a good opportunity to move up. So even the previous week low can act as a good support zone also. So until and unless if it is not engulfing this monthly CPR, we will be trending upside only. So comparing to Nifty and Bank Nifty, I feel it is based on that. Nifty is looking very narrow. Bank Nifty is looking like the same CPR or a bit wider than the previous month CPR. So Nifty can trend upside, or Nifty can trend any side if suppose Reliance is helping it. If Reliance is going to trend down, then Nifty can trend down. If Reliance is going to trend up, then Nifty can trend up. So bank stocks can rally, but not expecting much of its move, because already it has rallied a lot in the previous month. So that is why I'm not expecting much of the move in the Bank Nifty. Because Bank Nifty, if you guys see over here, 21,000 to the high of 25,230, nearly 5,000 points move has been seen. But in the case of Nifty, it is not the same. So, and also a good rejection is seen at the Nifty, but not the same in Bank Nifty. So overall conclusion for Nifty and Bank Nifty is looking sideways with a slight bearishness seen over there. If suppose the previous day low is getting broken, Monday's low is going to get broken, bearishness might get in fire. And then when in the case of Bank Nifty, it is looking sideways to bullish nature. I'm expecting more of sideways also bullish nature. But again, if suppose Monday's low is going to get broken, then we might see some dip. But anyways, a good support zones are seen in Bank Nifty, whereas the good support zones are not seen in Nifty. Let's see how the market is going to react. I have already shown you an example wherein the Nifty candle, if suppose the weekly candle, if it is not giving a good close, if suppose the weekly lows is not going to get good close, then we can see some trending upside move. The same way, if suppose this this day low or the previous day low, if it is not going to get broken, then we can see further upside move. Anyways, let's wait and track. We had a good close in Bank Nifty. Any pullback will be a buying opportunity in banks. So that is what I'm expecting. So let's move on further with this nature itself. So have a track of it. I'll just summarize it again. If suppose 31st August low is going to get broken, then Nifty can rally down, crack downside. The next supports are 11,250, 11,050, and then 10,850 is the levels we could see. And in the case of Bank Nifty, if suppose Bank Nifty is going to break the support of 21,385, then 23,250 will be the zone where we can see the next support, and after that 21,000 or the 22,000 will be acting as a good support zone. So this is all about Nifty as well as in Bank Nifty. I have shared over here. So please do let me know if in case of I missed anything. And there are several other news flowing around. So be cautious in the trade. Moreover, what I would say is like September is a month where you can get some good returns also. So let's see, even in the September over here, the August was in a very bearish side. And September first week, it took a support over here around 26,641 and took a high to 30,000. So nearly 4,000 points move was seen in 2019. And in 2018, it was also trending month. And 2017, it was a sideways month. So September is looking like a trending side. We have to catch up the side in which side it is going to trend. So this is all about the update which I wanted to share in the weekly analysis and monthly analysis with respect to Nifty and Bank Nifty. In the case of Today's market is very clean and neat. I don't want to explain with respect to CPR or anything. So it is a basic concept. Yesterday it was a trending move from nearly 11,800 to a fall to 11,300. Nearly 500 points fall is seen in Nifty, and we cannot expect the same fall to continue. And hence today's range was completely range bound. So what I would request each and everyone is, like, tomorrow's Nifty will be looking like a narrow CPR. So trade cautiously so that you will be able to win some good profits. So yes, tomorrow's Nifty is looking very, very narrow, and it is an inside value CPR also. So I would request each and everyone to trade cautiously so that you will be able to win some good profit. Any range breakout above the previous day, above this current day, which is a high of 11,555 and 11,420. If any range breakout is seen, then it might be a trending opportunity and it can go any side also. And that is the same video which I have applied, which I have used it in CPR video also, camera lock video also, which I uploaded in Secret of Pivot Boss book trading. So advanced members, kindly watch it so that you will be able to understand that. So let me check the tomorrow's CPR camera law point so that I will be able to understand. So tomorrow's camera law, it is slightly looking like an overvalue, overlapping higher value CPR, overlapping higher value narrow camera law pivot range. So it is also showing slightly bullish. CPR is showing inside value and it is also having a bullishness. So try to trade accordingly. And one more thing to note, today was an inside value day. Inside value day in the sense inside bar. So we have a high range. We have an high range in the upper side, and we don't have a high range in the lower side. So try to trade very cautiously in Nifty. So this is all about the update I wanted to say in this video about the weekly and the monthly analysis. If at all I have missed anything, kindly do let me know in the comment section. Share your feedback in the comment section so that it will encourage me as well as motivate me for further updates. And kindly like, share and subscribe. Please support. Thanks a lot. Stay tuned for more videos.